everyone. Pastor Tracy here. Just want to say that we, again, miss seeing everyone as often as we would like to. We are thankful that we're beginning to move in the direction where we have another option for you to join us with the Sunday mornings, you know, as far as the doors being open. So we're thankful that things are progressing that way. We hope you're doing well. I want to continue a little bit more in regards to love, and I want to share with you from Philippians chapter 1. Many times people wonder, you know, ways to pray. Like, how do we pray for people? What's some things I can pray for my loved ones? Things I can pray for myself. And it's really good to go to the epistles and look at the prayers that are there, because that is praying the word of God, which, you know, that is God speaking to us. So that's praying. That's one way that we know that we can pray effectively, because it's his word. So Philippians chapter 1, and starting in verse 4, it says, "Being confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Christ." So we can have confidence in knowing that he who has begun a good work in me, in you, will complete it till the day of Christ. So he's begun it, and who's going to complete it? Him. Sometimes we then know that God's begun a work, and then we go and try to complete it. But it's important to know that God's begun the work, and he's going to complete it. And we talked about the word complete, meaning like mature. He's going to help mature that work, grow that work, complete that work of what he has for us to do. It's not something that we have to just figure out all on our own. And then we can go on, and so an important part of us walking in the things of God and carrying out his will and purpose and being effective is a strong foundation of our love walk. So a good prayer for us, because it's important that we, sometimes people want to use a blanket term for love. Well, you should just love everybody. And that takeaway can be that then sometimes people get taken advantage of and can get hurt and things like that happening. And but they're told that in the name of love, they need to just, you know, get over it. But here's the thing. We can love. The Bible tells us in verse 9, it says, "This I pray, that your love may abound still more and more in knowledge and all discernment, that you may approve the things that are excellent, and that you may be sincere and without offense till the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are by Jesus Christ, to the glory and the praise of God." So it tells us here, this is an important thing for us to pray over ourselves, and especially over our kids as they're growing up, that we will have walk in love, that our love would abound more and more in knowledge and discernment. That we, you know, that's learning to love with the God kind of love, having knowledge and discernment, that we may approve the things that are excellent. And then going on down, it says, being filled with the fruits of righteousness, the fruits of right standing in Christ. And it's by Christ. Those fruits come from him to the glory and the praise of God. So spend some time meditating on that. Number one, knowing that he who has begun the work, he'll complete it in you. And knowing that that love foundation is important. And add to your approach to strengthening that foundation that you love with knowledge and discernment. And know that you are being filled with the fruits of righteousness, of that right standing, of knowing who we are in Christ. There's a fruit from that in our life. And so I just want to encourage you in that and let you know that we do love you and look forward to seeing you soon. Have an awesome day.